Welcome back to Morning Joe as we take a live look at Detroit. And let's bring in the governor right now. We're going to be there tomorrow. Obviously, we've got Rick Snyder with us. Governor, how are we progressing as far as bankruptcy goes? I understand, well, obviously, you still have to have court hearings. How are things moving forward?
Yeah, and I want to welcome you to Michigan tomorrow. I'm sorry I couldn't be with you then, but it's great to be with you today. We're making good progress in Detroit. And that's an important part of the message, is we're not waiting to go through bankruptcy and then have Detroit come back. Much of Detroit is already coming back, and the last obstacle is really this municipal question about getting better services to citizens, dealing with the debt with the bankruptcy. The private sector, the foundation community, the young people are moving in Detroit. A lot of exciting things are really going on, and this is our chance to really remove what I hope is the last major obstacle, which are getting better services, just as you heard. There's a blight issue, there's other issues, and we're going to keep working on
them. Hey, Brian Shackman.
Yeah, I think that a lot of people have talked about this aggressive urban planning that could happen in Detroit. Are we going to do something extremely creative with what happens after we get rid of some of this blight? I mean, it's a city that can handle 2 million that really only has about 700,000 right now. And if the city's going to thrive, it's never going to go back there. It's probably a healthy city at, you know, 1.2 million, right?
Yeah, and the good part is there's already a good plan that's been put in place, and I want to compliment the citizens of Detroit for doing that plan. It was a year-long plus planning process, and it's called the Detroit City Future Plan. And that's the roadmap we're using that shows many more green spaces, alternative uses of space, a really focus on the neighborhoods in terms of getting, you know, good, strong neighborhoods with good schools. So there is a format in place that we're following already.
Governor, yesterday a judge upticked the court dates. He moved it from October 23rd to September 18th. Is it to rule on whether Detroit has the right to file bankruptcy under Chapter 9? Is that what the court case is all about? And is it also accurate to say that part of the Michigan Constitution precludes any bankruptcy hearing from reducing pension benefits?
The first part is an accurate statement. It's really about the eligibility to be in bankruptcy, and that's the first stage of going through that process. And I appreciate the judge actually moving the timetable up, because we want to go promptly through this process. Your second question is more a legal question. The Michigan Constitution is not that specific about bankruptcy situations. It just talks about diminishing contract rights for pensions and such. And so that will be a question that the bankruptcy court probably will ultimately decide at some point during this process.
Carl Bernstein.
A related question, Governor. I think I understand your positions on Obamacare and municipal pensions. On Obamacare, you've accepted, you want to accept Medicaid funds, the expansion of the Medicaid exchanges. Why are you so different than your other Republican governors? Do you think Obamacare works? And secondly, you don't seem to want to defund municipal pensions, unlike your other Republican governors in neighboring states. Why is your position different, and is Detroit, is Michigan different, or is this something other Republican governors should be doing?
Yeah, well, those are a couple big questions. To take the first one on the Affordable Care Act, too often people generalize as one massive thing with the Affordable Care Act. My view is it needs to be broken down into appropriate components. There are a number of federal things that I am extremely troubled with, but one of the positives was looking at Medicaid expansion, particularly when you do it the way we're doing it here in Michigan, or talking about doing it, which is Healthy Michigan, which includes a wellness personal responsibility portion to the program. And so we just got Senate approval last night. We need to go to the House next week. And I look forward to seeing that put in place, because it's about helping 470,000 Michiganders, hardworking but lower income people, get health insurance instead of going to the ER.
Texans also? Excuse me. Wouldn't the same apply in helping Texans?
Well, I very much stay focused on the state of Michigan. That's the job I was hired to do, and there's an opportunity to help Michiganders here. And we're doing it in a good way. We've had a good track record with Medicaid. We've been one of the most efficient states. And Healthy Michigan, which includes an opportunity for people to pay a premium but also reduce that premium because of having a good health care plan, is very much a positive element. So I would encourage other states to look at what we're doing. And then with respect to pensions, again, there's a lot of issues that will go through the bankruptcy in Detroit. But one thing we've done at the state level at Michigan is make sure we properly fund our pension liabilities and our health care liabilities. And that's something the public sector really needs to look at hard at. We forecast through the year 2040 here for our liabilities, and we put payment plans in place. So in many respects, we're going to be paying down most of our major liabilities at the state of Michigan level by about 2038 as we stay on track with this plan.
Richard Wolf.
Governor, I'd like to ask about voting laws. You have photo ID requirements in Michigan, but last year you vetoed an attempt to beef up those photo ID requirements in your state. I'm wondering what you think of the North Carolina laws that were recently signed into law. Do you think there's more to do in terms of photo ID?
Well, again, I don't really speculate on other state situations. I stick to my state because that's what I was hired to do, and there's so many important issues we are resolving here. We're making a strong comeback. And with respect to voters and voter rights, voting rights are absolutely imperative. And the issue I had in the past was really looking at what people were required to sign about giving so much information about absentee ballots. And we made that simpler and clearer.
Governor Rick Snyder, thanks very much for joining us. We appreciate it. We're going to be in Detroit tomorrow. I'm going to the Tigers game tonight when I get there. Hopefully they'll win too.
Go Tigers.
Yeah, absolutely.